super excited to be here. I have a lot to say and not a lot of time to say it. So as usual, let's get into it. 8 years ago, I co-founded a startup called Nozzle.io, where we build enterprise search monitoring tools. And for anybody who doesn't speak SEO, that just means SEO analytics. While we were building Nozzle over this long period of time, we used a lot of open source and love open source software. We've also been able to contribute a lot of open source back to the ecosystem through TanStack. So tools like TanStack Query and Table and Virtual were all born out of challenges and solutions that we experienced while building Nozzle. Today, I want to talk about one more of those challenges and solutions that we've encountered and how we are solving it today. We're talking about routing. Yeah. So at Nozzle, we maintain a massive single-page application. Boo, right? Nobody really likes to talk about single-page apps, but they're the underrepresented middle class of front-end development. Anybody manage a single-page app? Yeah! All right. Single-page apps are great. And at Nozzle, we have a lot of dashboards, a lot of widgets. You can only imagine why I've built most of the tools that I've built. But we also have a ton of links. Links that comprise the primary user experience that all of our clients have when they're navigating through Nozzle. There are so many of them, and they really have limitless permutations because whether they're drilling through from one dashboard to the next or just changing all of the widgets on the screen or you know, updating really anything, it kind of begs the question of what does it take to move a user from here to there? It's not as simple as just some paths in your URL. At Nozzle, when we move users from here to there, it means managing massive amounts of state. State that's tied to widgets, to dashboards, to essentially the entire experience the user is having on the screen. This is just one of the smallest dashboards we have, and this is the initial state that comes with that dashboard. And when I saw something like this, my gut reaction, probably like yours, was that, wow, this has got to be like global state, right? Or maybe server state, if you want to get crazy. But the truth is that those are both the wrong tools to manage what we're talking about, because we need everything to be a link. And links are amazing because they are the oldest, most primitive form of portable state for the web. When I'm talking about why links are amazing, they are shareable, they're bookmarkable, they work great with the history APIs in our browsers, and you can command click into new tabs. They enable so much of what we do on the web. So the way that we can control these links is we need some way to manage our state inside of this URL structure, serializing our state, pulling it back out, essentially turning it into paths, path params, and search parameters. The tools we have to do this today are pretty good. Next.js and React Router have very wonderful APIs for working with search parameters and path params. Things like router.push, setparams, links, use navigate. These are all wonderful tools to work with search parameters and paths. But something I have found, technical difficulties. Something I have found that working with URL state at Nozzle is that these APIs generally assume that we're working with very few search parameters, that we're working with flat key value pairs, and that honestly, everything is a string. Have you ever tried putting a number into the URL and bringing it back out? Really, when you try and scale state management into the URL, you are met with a very unpolished developer experience. So in reality, state tends to grow beyond what we think it's going to be. It tends to get large, nested, and ultimately turns into JSON. And that's exactly what happens when you start to manage a lot of state in the URL. We don't just have to manage this state, but we have to stringify it into the URL and pull it back out again all the time, anytime that it's changing. And this is an actual URL that I have. We're not base64ing it here because this isn't very URL safe. But this is the size of URLs that we're passing around in Nozzle all the time. So we're not just talking about state management. We're talking about serialized state management. Anybody who's used React Query knows that this is a super easy problem to solve, right? Not at all. Anytime that you serialize state, you run into new challenges that you never thought you would have. Things like maintaining referential stability across parsing and serialization. You have to provide immutable update APIs to make sure that you're only changing the things that need to change. You have to think about schema and validation, because after all, this is just a string in an input box at the top of your user's browser. They can put whatever they want there, and whatever you pull out of there, your application needs to be ready to handle it, or to handle it gracefully. Validation is really important when we're talking about search parameters and URLs in general because of the nature of how they work. I want to talk a little bit more about validation, and I want to start with a simple link. We probably all have links that look like this in our applications. We're going to a new page, and we're setting a couple of search parameters. So right here, we're sorting by age, and we're filtering by true. I don't know about you guys, but I don't really know that we can sort by age or that we can filter by a Boolean. Maybe we can, maybe we can't. I honestly don't know. How about we dial it back a little further and just look at a link to a new page? It seems harmless. We're just moving to a new page. But in reality, one of your colleagues could come and change the route path or change the file name. And now, magically, all of the links to this page are broken. And the harsh reality that we live in today is that you are probably not going to know about those breaks until you ship them to your users. Your users are going to find them for you because we have no idea that anything happened at all. This is a really big problem. And it really comes down to fundamental type safety concerns over all of our routing APIs that we have been OK using over the years, including myself. APIs ranging everything from paths, search params, all the way down to like modern APIs like loaders and actions. Literally everything that we use is unsafe or requires a lot of brittle typecasting to be beneficial to the rest of our system. At TanStack, you're probably well aware, we take state management and type safety very seriously. I've been working very hard over the last year, year and a half, to bring you something new. And today, I made a video to show you what we've been working on. TanStack Router is our new router for building applications. It's 100% type safe, the entire API. It's got amazing search parameter APIs for managing state like you're used to. And something we didn't even talk about, it has built-in caching, which we'll get to in a minute. The type safety in TanStack Router is so cool. It is fully inferred all the way from your route definitions down to the call sites and rendering and usage that you have in your components and your routes. What this really means is that everywhere you go with your router, you have autocomplete, whether that's navigating to a new path, a relative navigation, or trying to pass some new search params or update only part of them. You have instant feedback for what is possible with your route configuration. And you're notified instantly if you're doing something that is going to be illegal. The search parameter APIs are really just something else. The schemas and validations that you can create for your search parameters make it so that you can ensure your app is only receiving data and state that you want it to. You can use schemas from Zod or Yup or whatever you want to validate your search parameters. And make sure that those types propagate all the way through to the rest of the API. There's custom parsing and serialization. All of the search parameter API has immutability and structural sharing built in. So this really just means you're not triggering unwanted side effects as you, update this serialized state in this URL. There's also advanced things like pre and post processing middleware, so you have very granular control over every single search parameter that is generated for every link in your entire application. Let's talk about the built-in caching. This one really happened very recently. We took everything we've learned from TanStack Query, and we put the best parts right into the router. This means that all of your loaders have stale while revalidate and custom max age support. Everything has auto invalidation when you start using actions. There's automatic garbage collection. We even have automatic prefetching so that when we detect intent for your users to go to a new route, we can preload everything for you to make sure that it's there when they click the link. We also realize that having all of your cache live inside of your router may not fit every single use case, including some of our own. So we made sure to make it external cache friendly so it will work with external utilities like TanStack Query. It's framework agnostic, which means we have a core that handles a lot of the logic, the lifecycle, and the state for the router. And then we have framework adapters that wrap this up into a nice little package for your UIs. Today, we have a React adapter available, and we're working on all of the other ones, except for Angular, which will cost you $100,000, or you can build it on your own. If you want to try it today, you can install it with @tanstack/react-router@beta. Yes, we're launching beta today to get some early feedback, and we're going to 1.0 very soon. If you want to learn more and see the examples that should have been in this talk, you can go to tanstack.com/router. Have to end with showing off some of our great sponsors at TanStack. Wouldn't be able to build awesome software like this without the help of all of these companies and individuals. So thank you to all my sponsors, and thank you to all of you for having me here.